There are many ways that we can analyze the genomic sequencing data to identify variants or mutations. One of the most obvious solution that we would do would be just sequence and assemble the individual genome from scratch, similar to de novo sequencing, and then assembled back using the assembly methods that we already know and compare it against the reference genome and identify places where the variants occur. But computationally, constructing a genome from scratch takes a lot of memory and computational power. Alternatively, we can use the reference genome which share 99% similarity between individual and need not to start from the scratch. That would allow us to identify variants or mutations more efficiently. Read mapping aims to determine where each read generated by the sequencing machine has high similarity to the reference gene. Unlike de novo sequencing which assemble from scratch, read mapping algorithms take each of the sequencing reads and align to the reference genome to identify if there is any variation in the query sequence. For example, there is a perfect substring match here, a substitution here, and we a deletion there. We're going to focus on a simpler question now which is going to help us generalize the problem. Where do the reads match the genome reference exactly? If we can answer this question, then maybe we can generalize it. For example, if we're given a single read, we will consider it as a string pattern and compare it with a larger string which is the genome. The challenge is to figure out which positions that pattern matches the genome as a substring. So, all we're doing then is generalizing this to multiple reads on multiple patterns. We're finding, given a collection of patterns, where are those patterns match exactly in the larger genome. One way to solve this is to use a brute force approach by slide the pattern down the genome. Imagine if you had a pattern nana and you were looking in the genome with a pattern panamabananas. If we want to find the exact matches, then we simply slide it down. We see in the first position, P and N don't match, so we slide it down. A and N don't match, and then in the third position we see a match of N. The second position also matches, so we see two matches. But the third position doesn't match. So we slide the pattern down to the next position. No match, no match, no match, no match. And then we finally reach an N again, and we see that there is a pattern match there. Then we're at the end of the string. So, this seems like a perfectly reasonable approach. We take each pattern, and we just slide it down the genome. And find out where the pattern matches. Although the brute force approach can solve the multiple pattern matching problem, the approach takes a lot of time and forces us to slide the patterns along the genome multiple times if there is more than one read. In brute force method, the combined length of all the patterns is huge. And this algorithm is not that practical for multiple reads. So, instead of asking individual patterns to go along the genome one at a time, we can pack all of the patterns into a single structure and move this structure along the genome only once. This data structure is called a trie, coming from the word retrieval. The trie is a data structure for representing a collection of patterns and support fast pattern matching. If we were given a set of patterns, the idea is to combine all these patterns into a rooted tree, with branches labeled by letters. Every string in the patterns corresponds to a path from the root to a leaf. For example, to understand how we can construct a trie from a collection of patterns, we start with a root. The first pattern is banana. From the root, the first character of banana is B. The next character is A. We continue on and so forth. The next pattern, PAN. We start from the root. There is no P, so we have to create a new branch P here, and then A and N. So, we continue to create the rest of the branch. The resulted rooted tree is called a trie, constructed from a set of patterns. So, a trie is a rooted tree with branches labeled by letters in the alphabet. Every pattern is a path from the root to the leaf. The question now is, how to use the tree for pattern matching? Let's assume that we have the string, that's the genome, panamabananas. To match the trie to the genome, we put the trie at the first position of the string, P, and then we ask whether there is any pattern in the connection that can match at the P position on the genome. We found there is a P nearest to the root, so there is a P match. We walk down A and N. At this position, we can find a match, pan. We then move the trie to the next position. We try to walk down the tree from the root to the leaf of the tree, to find if there is any match. We could find A here, next one is N, and the next is A, but there is no M in our tree. So, it doesn't match. If we continue on, the trie data structure will allow us to retrieve a pattern from the collection very quickly. Although the trie's approach greatly speed up the runtime and multiple pattern matching, it requires huge memory to process. For example, here is the trie that we are working with for the patterns that we had, and you can verify that the number of edges in this trie is approximately equal to the combined length of all our patterns. This is not necessarily great because the combined length of patterns of NGS reads can be 40 or 50 times the length of the genome. So that's a huge amount of memory that we are going to have to use. Rather than processing the patterns or reads into a data structure, can we instead flip this around and process the genome into a data structure? If this data structure used the combined length of genome, then that would be a huge memory reduction. Here is what we are going to do. We are going to perform all suffixes of our genome. For example, consider this hypothetical genome panamabananas. To form the suffix trie, we will add a dollar sign to denote the end of the string. Remember that when we used the trie before, we said, at each position of the genome, is it possible to spell down a pattern from the root to a leaf of the trie? In this case, what we're going to do is, let's take each pattern and see if we can spell out that pattern from the root downward in the suffix trie. Here is an example. Here is the pattern banana. And we know that occurs in Panama bananas. If we start at the root, then we go to B, and we can spell it down this path, and we see that we spell out the entire string banana and end at this node. What that tells us is we were able to spell it out in the suffix trie, and that means that it must be a pattern match. Next, we have nab, and we know that doesn't occur in Panama bananas. We can match the first two letters following this path, but we're unable to match the third letter. Antenna is another pattern that we know doesn't occur. We can match the first two letters, but again not the third. If we continue on, we will be able to identify which pattern matched to the genome Panama bananas. The next question that we need to ask is, where is it that these matches are located? For example, if we look at the pattern nana, we know that it matches to the genome. But this does not presently give us any information about where that match occurred in a string. So, to find where these patterns matches are, we are going to need to add a little bit more information to the suffix trie that we have. At each leaf of the trie, what we are going to do is we'll add the starting position of the suffix, that whose path ends at that leaf. When we walk down the suffix to a leaf, we'll add the position at the leaf where the suffix originally started in the genome. For example, if we come back to our trie for Panama bananas, the entire string as a suffix, it starts at position 0. For Panama bananas, here is the path that ends at the leaf, and so we label it with 1, which is the starting position of that suffix. And so we find each path through the genome or through the tree corresponding to a suffix and label it with subsequent integers. Once we found a match, we're simply going to walk down to the leaf to find out what the position of that match was. For example, if we look at the pattern banana, we found that banana is a match, and so we simply walk down through the nodes to the leaf, and we see that the starting position is 6. Another example would be Anna. This occurs in 3 different places in Panama bananas. When we found the match, we are nowhere near a leaf yet. In fact, we are at a node that branches. So, to find the starting position of all matches of Anna, we need to walk down each of these 3 paths to a leaf. If we walk down this path, we get starting position 1. If we walk down this path, we get starting position 7. And if we walk down this path, we get starting position 9. This tells us that Anna have 3 starting positions, 1, 7 and 9. One of the issues here is that the suffix trie can be much bigger than the trie that we had for the patterns. In fact, if the genome has length end, the combined of suffixes is equal to end multiplied by end minus 1 divided by 2. We are dealing with something that's now quadratic in the length of genome. This is not going to be practical for a real genome. One way to overcome this is to compress the trie. To do this, we are going to take each non-branching path of tree and compress that into one edge that represents the string along that path. This data structure is called a suffix tree. This gives us a reasonable total runtime and memory for read mapping.